Energy-efficient LED plant lights or grow lights are a possible lighting of the future of agriculture. LEDs, or light-emitting diodes, are small electronic components made of two types of semiconductor material, one having a negative charge called electrons, and the other having a positive charge called holes. When voltage is properly applied over an LED, electric current starts to flow through it, making electrons and holes start to collide with each other, which makes them release energy in the form of photons. This process is called recombination. Modern LEDs have high brightness and can come in a variety of colors in visible, infrared, and ultraviolet spectral ranges. As suggested by their name, LED plant lights or grow lights utilize LED chips in an efficient way to produce light similar to that of the sun's for growing plants. One of the advantages to grow lights compared to traditional lighting is the ability to match the light to the needs of the plants. Various studies have shown that certain colors of light influence plant growth in different ways, affecting root and flower formation such as blue and red light. This means that the majority of all plants will complete a normal growth cycle if exposed to both blue and red grow lights. Adding other colors to the spectrum, such as green, far red, and deep blue, helps the plant by giving it more information about its environment and overall resulting in higher quality plants. A spectrum that contains all colors is called full spectrum and mostly resembles the sunlight. If it has high proportions of green, the light will appear white to human eyes. And while not a large factor for plant growth, this does make the work around these lights easier and makes visual inspection of the plants possible. White and pink LED grow lights are both full spectrum. Through research, we can determine the optimal light for growing plants. It is important to consider that different plants react differently to various light changes and treatment. For example, a plant in its flowering phase may require a different light treatment as opposed to when it's in the vegetative stage. When it comes to the light itself, several parameters can be modified, such as light spectrum, light intensity, photoperiod, and light uniformity. And once again, please consider liking this video, and thanks for watching.